When it comes to reviewing Twitch streamers, no matter if they are brand new to streaming or if they've been at it for a while and maybe have managed to hit affiliate or even partner level, there are two major technical mistakes that I see people making. Either their stream actually for the viewer that is watching has some sort of technical issue like buffering or an inconsistent video frame rate or maybe drop frames or something like that, or they just haven't spent the time properly optimizing their settings. They might have a decent looking stream, but have they really spent the time analyzing and configuring to squeeze the absolute best quality out of their connection to Twitch? In this video, we are going to be looking at four different tools ranging from the super basic all the way up to the more advanced tools that are going to help you properly analyze and optimize your Twitch stream. And as a bonus, we'll also be looking at a tool that you can use to analyze other people's streams if you want to know exactly what their broadcast settings are too. All coming up after a message from our sponsor. Nerd or Die has just released the follow-up to one of their most popular stream packs, Glitch 2. This design features glitch, distortion, and futuristic animations, including alerts that integrate nicely with your webcam frame. This whole pack is completely customizable and works for both Streamlabs and Stream Elements. So grab yourself 10% off at checkout using the link in the description below. Right, so the first and most basic tools are the OBS or Streamlabs OBS auto configuration wizards. These are just short tests that are built directly into the streaming software, designed to help you get things like your bitrate, your resolution, your frame rate, and your server choice correct. In the OBS wizard, there are some questions that you need to answer about how you intend to use the software. Are you going to be using it primarily for streaming or for recording, what your base resolution or canvas resolution is, and what your preferences are for FPS, if you prefer a 60 FPS stream at the cost of resolution, or if you prefer a higher resolution at the cost of FPS. There's also some options about what service you're going to be streaming to, obviously Twitch, and if you want to use hardware encoding as well as running a bandwidth test. I'd recommend enabling all three of those, and then when the test has finished running, it will show you a screen with all the different settings it will apply if you choose to. If you are using Streamlabs OBS, it's a much simpler test. It doesn't ask you any questions, but it actually really annoyingly also doesn't show you what settings it has adjusted when the test has complete. So it's a bit annoying because you then have to jump into your settings to actually look at your bitrate, your frame rate, your resolution, things like that, to see actually what settings Streamlabs OBS applied. The advantages of both of these tests are that they are quick and they're built into the software that you're already using. But obviously the disadvantages are that the connection test doesn't really run for long enough to properly analyze your internet for instabilities. And the test also doesn't simulate you actually running and playing a game on your computer, so it doesn't stress your CPU or your GPU in quite the same way. The second tool that we're going to be using is called TwitchTest. It's an application developed by a guy called Rich. I've been recommending this application since I started this YouTube channel way back when I first started creating some OBS tutorials, because it's a super lightweight Windows program that allows you to perform some bandwidth tests to each of the Twitch ingest servers, so the actual servers that you're going to be streaming to all around the world. So you can pick an ingest server that has sufficient bandwidth for your connection, a low round trip time, and a high quality rating, which will help ensure that you achieve the best results when streaming. The reason that this is useful is because it's not always true that the server that is geographically closest to where you live is the best. Usually that is the case, but it's well worth running a test to make sure that you're getting a high quality connection and choosing an ingest server that will be best for you. To actually run the test, all you need to do is download the application. I'll include a link in the description down below so you can download it yourself, and then just paste in your stream key from your Twitch dashboard. Change the TCP window size just to automatic, which is what OBS uses, and then select the region of the world that you live in and set the test duration to whatever you want. Obviously, a longer test will provide a better representation of your internet stability, but it will take longer because it's going to run that duration for each of the servers in that region. Then all you have to do is click start. Twitch test will then simulate streams to all of the ingest servers that Twitch has available in that selected region, and then display the results after each test has completed. I hope it goes without saying that for all of these tests, for all of these different tools that we're using, you should obviously be avoiding using any internet heavy applications when they're running, because they are going to skew your results. A lot of these applications are testing your internet connection, so avoid using anything like Steam or torrenting or even streaming things on YouTube. When all the tests are finished, you should be looking for the server with the highest bandwidth available while still maintaining a quality result above 80. If two servers are tied, then choose the one with the higher quality. And if the quality is tied, then choose the one with the lower round trip time. Now, the purpose of this tool isn't just to choose which ingest server you should be streaming to. It's also to change and actually set your bitrate inside of OBS or Streamlabs OBS. So for bitrate, I'd recommend that you set this to 80% of your bandwidth figure here, while still not exceeding Twitch's soft cap of 6,000 kilobits per second. And bear in mind that just because you can stream at 6,000 kilobits per second and you have the internet capable of it, doesn't mean that you should. If you aren't partnered or one of the bigger affiliates, Twitch is very unlikely to transcode your stream into various different quality options. So you know that when you watch some big streamers, you see down in the bottom corner that you can change it from 1080p to 720p to 480p, just depending on your connection. And if you're watching from mobile, it'll do this all automatically. You won't get those options if you're not a partnered streamer or an affiliate that has a higher number of viewers. So just because you can stream at 6,000 kilobits per second doesn't mean that you should, because if you don't have these options, it'll mean that your viewers also have to have internet capable of downloading 6,000 kilobits per second. And a lot of people are watching on mobiles now and probably won't have that kind of connection. So the stream can appear stuttery and buffery for them, even if your upload and your stream is actually doing fine. So with that being said, if you are a smaller streamer without those transcode options, I'd recommend you set your bitrate to 80% of your bandwidth with a maximum of 3,500 kilobits per second. If you're partnered on Twitch, then I would recommend using 80% of your bandwidth with a maximum of 6,000 kilobits per second. Tool number three that we're going to be using is quite a bit more advanced, and it's called Twitch Inspector. It's actually been built by Twitch itself, and the Inspector analyzes and assists you in troubleshooting your internet connection or encoder related issues whilst broadcasting to Twitch. Basically, it allows you to run a test stream to Twitch servers without actually going live to your audience, and then provides real-time analysis of your bitrate and your frame rate and things like that. You can then use this graph data along with their help articles, which allows you to find the cause of your problems in your stream, including low internet bandwidth, excessive high bitrate, and you know, the classic encoding hardware problems. The great thing about this test and the Twitch Inspector in general is that it's actually an exact simulation of your stream. You know, you can play the game, you run OBS, and you're using all of your actual stream settings to really test your PC and your connection exactly as you would if you were streaming out to your audience. To run a test, all you need to do is simply log in with your Twitch account and authorize its access, and then click to run a stream test, which will give you a little pop-up with a bit of text that you need to append to the end of your stream key in OBS or Streamlabs OBS. This little bit of text just prevents you from actually going live to your audience and tells Twitch that instead you're running a test stream for the purposes of analyzing problems. Copy this text and paste it in after your stream key in OBS or Streamlabs OBS, and then click to start your stream. You'll need to wait 10 to 20 seconds for Twitch Inspector to actually recognize your new stream, but the page will automatically refresh and you should be able to click through to this larger graph and analysis of your stream. If possible, I'd recommend streaming for at least 15 minutes just to see exactly how stable things are, and you know, give it a chance to detect any kind of problems. If you do have a problem, the inspector should recognize them, and then the help articles there will offer solutions for exactly what you need to change based on your results. Most likely the things that you'll need to do are lower your bitrate, your resolution, or your frame rate, or some combination of the three to prevent either your internet or your encoder from causing issues. Remember that a 1080p 60fps stream might be what you want to send out to the world, but that is not easy to achieve by any means. And in many cases, actually a 720p stream at 60fps or a 720p stream at 30fps may be the best you can get with your current setup and connection. It's worth remembering that a 1080 stream, the resolution actually requires over double the number of pixels that a 720p resolution stream requires. So a much higher bitrate is required for a 1080p stream to actually look good. The final tool that we're going to be looking at not only helps us analyze our own streams, but also anyone else who is live streaming to Twitch. This one has also been developed by Rich and it's called Twitch Analyzer. This one is super simple to use. Simply head to the link that I've included in the description and type in the name of any streamer that is currently live on Twitch. Now, this could be yourself, it could be a friend, or it could even be one of the bigger streamers that you're interested in seeing exactly what bit rates and frame rates and things like that that they are streaming at. The tool then takes a 10-second sample of the stream and analyzes that video data for things like resolution, frame rate, bit rate, if you're dropping frames, what your keyframes are set to, and things like that. And it does a great job of actually recognizing issues from this data and offering solutions on then how you can fix them. I've got to be honest, I'm always using this tool when I'm reviewing streamers from the Gaming Careers Patreon to offer feedback and just get a much better understanding of the actual technical side of what they are pushing to Twitch. One word of warning for this tool though is just remember that copying somebody else's stream settings most likely is not going to work for you. Just because you see somebody streaming the same game as you and you really like their settings doesn't mean that it's going to work for you, because you're using a different computer, you're located in a different part of the world, you're streaming to a different server and you have a different internet connection. You need to really be applying your own settings to your stream. It's just useful to be able to see what other people are being able to do. So using a combination of these four tools, hopefully you can now properly analyze, fix any issues with your stream, and really make sure that you're getting the best out of your connection to Twitch. If you have any more stream related questions, I would highly recommend joining the Gaming Careers Discord if you haven't already. We have nearly 5,000 members in there now, people helping each other out with all things streaming related. So again, I'll put a link in the description if you want to join the Discord community. And if you haven't yet subscribed to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, obviously I'd recommend doing that also and hitting that notification bell so that you don't miss an upload. A massive thanks as always to the Gaming Careers patrons. These people let me run this channel full time and keep creating this kind of content for you guys. Hopefully you found this video helpful. You can check out some of my other videos here on this page. And subscribers, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.